Pakistan is losing grip over Balochistan, and China could lose its prized quadruport. China is facing a new challenge in its geopolitical goals to directly reach the Arabian Sea through the Gwadar port in Pakistan, instead of sailing around South Asia, an area that is traditionally influenced by India and the Indian Navy. Located in the Balochistan province of Pakistan, the Gwadar port and other Chinese investments are facing a direct threat from the Baloch Liberation Army. The struggle against the oppressive Pakistani regime in Balochistan is no longer aimed at just against Islamabad, but also against Beijing, as the Baloch people have realized how the occupational forces in the region are today backed and led by China. Recently, Pakistani security forces abandoned their checkposts in Balochistan after they came under heavy stone pelting from protesters. The protests had erupted in Brabcha, Balochistan, and spread across the entire province on Wednesday after a 4-year-old was shot down by Pakistan army-backed terrorists in Turbat city. A strong reaction has come from Baloch activists, and the Baloch Republican Party has come down heavily on the Pakistan army over this gruesome incident. It has termed this incident as a continuation of the massacre by Pakistan armed forces in Balochistan, who have been engaged in kidnapping civilians for ransom and dumping mutilated bodies for the last several years. This is bad news for China, as it directly jeopardizes its ambitious China-Pakistan Economic Corridor Project, or the CPEC, which links China's far western Xinjiang province to the Gwadar port. Beijing has invested $60 billion in this project that also passes through Aksai Chin and Pakistan-occupied Jammu and Kashmir. This is the primary reason why India rejected the Belt and Road Initiative, because China showed utter disregard for Indian sovereignty when it went ahead with the CPEC. The Gwadar port itself is being developed at a massive cost of $1.62 billion, and Beijing's ultimate aim here is to gain a strong foothold over the Arabian Sea and hence the Indian Ocean region. In fact, China is looking to build a naval base in Gwadar that will complement its first overseas military base in Djibouti. China's aim is to checkmate India in India's own backyard. In fact, China is already on to something. According to Forbes, recent satellite images appear to show that several new complexes have been built in the last few years in Gwadar. One of them identified as being used by a Chinese company involved in port development has unusually high security. The magazine added that the high security compound has been identified as being used by the China Communications Construction Company. This is a majority state-owned company that is heavily involved in many Chinese civil engineering projects. While some degree of security is normal in the region, the level of security seen here is extensive. Satellite images also reveal vehicle berms, security fences, and a high wall. Sentry posts and elevated guard towers cover the perimeter between the fence and the inner wall. This suggests armed guards with rifles. Last year, two smaller sites were also built at the Gwadar port. Forbes has reported that it has been suggested that these might be barracks for a Chinese Marine Corps garrison. Clearly, China has plans to build a military base at the Gwadar port. But this is where the problem begins. Gwadar is located in Balochistan, where the Baloch freedom movement is on a rise. The Pakistani army is under constant siege, and the Chinese projects are under a constant security threat, apart from the general opposition from the public in this region. Beijing wants to avoid sailing through South China Sea and wants to reach the Middle East, the African and European markets directly through road and rail travel to the Gwadar port and further shipping from the Baloch port city. The CPEC and the Gwadar port are at the core of China's trillion-dollar Belt and Road initiative. But things haven't been moving at an impressive pace. And even though a deal was recently struck to allow an Afghanistan-bound trading ship to use the port, the fact remains that the port hasn't really kicked off. Last year, China's COSCO shipping lines terminated its container liner services between Karachi and Gwadar, alleging that Pakistan's inadequate policies and measures have impacted market development. What has also fomented trouble for China is the Balochistan Liberation Army that seeks an independent state for the Baloch people. Pakistan is an occupational force in Balochistan, and the Baloch struggle is old, and the BLA insurgents routinely target Pakistani armed forces, personnel and naval officers. Islamabad's decision to hand over the Gwadar ports to Beijing on a 45-year lease without even consulting the Baloch people proved to be the last straw for the Baloch. Over the past 2 years, the Baloch insurgents have targeted Chinese investments in Gwadar, such as the five-star Zawar Pearl Continental Hotel, and the Baloch insurgents have also carried out an attack on the Chinese consulate in Karachi in 2018. In fact, while the BLA initially focused on Pakistani security personnel and Pakistani Punjabi settlers or encroachers, it has now started targeting Chinese nationals. The Majid Brigade of the BLA, formed in 2011, has in particular attacked Chinese nationals and Chinese-funded projects. China has every reason to grow more and more conscious about the security of the Gwadar port. China is already well positioned to buy out the Pakistani government as Pakistan is drowning in Chinese debt. So in order to protect its investments, it is very likely that if the Pakistani army continues to abandon its positions in Balochistan, China might try to take matters in its own hands.